This is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. This set of videos is going to look at Socrative. I'm going to go through it as quickly as I can. I'm going to try and do three things. Firstly, show you what an actual quiz looks like if we do one. So I'm going to look at it from the teacher's point of view and from the student's point of view. Secondly, I'm going to build a Socrative quiz right in front of your eyes and test it so you can see exactly how we make one. Thirdly, I'm going to look at the space race option and the exit ticket just to make these two final options very clear. So let's get straight in and quickly look at an example that will help us to understand how to make a Socrative. Now you do need an account to work with Socrative. Only the teacher needs to log in. The students log in somewhere completely different and do not need to sign up and do not need to give their email address. Only the teacher needs to do that. So you will need to click on Socrative and you will need obviously to create an account for yourself. So you will click here on get an account. Now I'm going to guess that you're already logged in and I'm going to show you what you see when you have logged in, and let's start straight away to look at this great tool and some of the possibilities of how we can work with it. So I'm logged into Socrative and there are two or three key things you need to learn about. One, this is your room. This is the name of your room. This is the room, the code that you will need to give to the students. You will always have the same room. I'm presuming, of course, that you have got a free account. Secondly, the most important thing for you will be where you launch your quizzes and where you create your quizzes. All these buttons here are quite useful, but these two are the most important. And obviously to create a quiz, we click here and then we're going to click on add quiz, and you can see all my quizzes here. And to launch a quiz, we click here, we choose the type of quiz we want to launch, and then we launch it. Now what I thought would be interesting for me to do first was to actually show you a quiz. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to log into one of my quizzes as a teacher, and then I'm going to show you exactly what the student sees as well. And you can do this, it's quite a clever trick, by logging in on one browser as a teacher and then using the student access and using the code to log in as a student on the other. So let's have a look at a Socrative quiz in action. So let's launch a quiz then and then look at what the students see. So I'm going to click here on quiz. It just asked me, do I want to stop the current activity? I'm going to say yes. It's going to then ask me, well, what quiz do you want to launch? Well, I'm going to launch this one here, History of the Kings and Queens. I click on next. And then I'm going to got three choices now. And understanding these choices is quite important. This one means basically that the teacher controls when the next question is available to the students. And in both of these, the student is in control. So these are quite similar. Really, this one just gives feedback immediately after each question, and this one gives feedback at the end. So I tend to choose this one. And I also tend to choose that the students get their final score. Now these are settings that you'll have to learn to work with, but I'm going to click on start now, and it immediately launches the game. And as you can see, it's now waiting for students to begin to log in. Now this here is the room number, so the students now need to log in and with that number on a different account, and I'm going to show you that now, and then the students can start to do the activity. So let's have a look at it now from the student's point of view. If the students go to Socrative.com or they download an app, all they need to do is click on student login. There's no need for them to put any email addresses or anything. They simply put the name of the class into their login and then add their name. So in our case, jumping back to the teacher view, we can see that the class is TDRL1SQ. So I add TRR1SQ, and I click on join. I then write my name, so I'm going to write Russell, and then I will join the room. Now instantly the questions begin because we've set it to what we call student mode, where the student controls the question. So let's start to answer a few questions. The king was restored after the Civil War in England. Which king? So the answer is it's Charles II. I click there. I get instant feedback because that is what I set in the settings for the teacher. Come to the next question. Henry VIII married 6 times. The answer is true, and submit the answer. And again, we can see, get the instant feedback. Move on to the next question. His first wife was Catherine of Aragon. Okay, so we begin to answer the questions. Now let's have a quick look at what the teacher is seeing at this moment in time. Now notice that the teacher can see exactly how many students have logged in. Well, in this case, it's just myself. how many questions each student has answered. Well, in this case, I've answered the three first, and it tells me that I got them all correct. Now, I could project this onto the screen, and if I didn't want anyone to see the answers, well, I can turn the answers off. So that way, if you wanted to just kind of do it as a race, who's doing the best, and even if you want to turn the student's name off, you can do that as well. So it's quite nice to project this onto the screen so the students can see in competition with other students what progress they're making. You've got a couple of options in terms of what information you reveal. And you can have, I mean, I've done quizzes with literally hundreds of students online at the same time. So, you know, you can have a huge list here of students that are working through the questions. Remember, I've set my quiz as student-paced. You can also do a quiz as teacher-paced as well. So I'm going to quickly finish this quiz and then show you what the teachers see at the end, just to give you a bit of an idea of what information the teachers finally get once the quiz is completed. So I've just finished the quiz. I got 75% on that quiz. Let's just now go and have a look at what the teacher would see. And the teacher would get all of this information about the student. And then once the teacher has, all the students have completed the quiz, the teacher can click on finish. And they've got various options here. And they can view a chart, they can get a report. So for example, we can click on this chart and it gives us some information. It's actually kind of the same information that we've saw anyway. If we click on this one, we can actually get a report and download it as well. And that can be really useful if you want to look at where students are having problems and where you need to perhaps give them some feedback. Say for example, we can see here that the student got two answers incorrect. Okay, so we've now seen what it's like if a student does a quiz and how the teacher does the quiz. Now let's actually create one. So when it comes to making quizzes, click here, click on quizzes, and simply click on add. Now we can import quizzes, we'll look at that later, but what we can do here is create a new quiz, and that's the most important. Now we're going to give this quiz a title. We're going to call this Quiz About Britain. And simply we now choose what type of question we want to add. Now when we work with Socrative, we've got three choices. We'll start with a multiple choice one. So we're going to click on this one here. And notice that you can immediately, you're going to write your question here, your possible answers here. You need to tell Socrative what the correct answer is. This feedback area is particularly important. Remember, after each question, particularly if you use it in student mode, then you can provide feedback to the students. Notice you can also add a picture if you want to do that. And notice also you can add more answer options. I'm going to just work with the first three. Socrative will work out how many options to offer depending on how many you complete. So let's write in a question, and I'll stop the video while I quickly write in a question just to save time. Okay, so here is my question. Here are my possible answers. I need to tell it which is the correct one. You can actually have more than one correct answer if that's an option. Here I've added some nice feedback. I've kind of built on this question and provide a little bit more detail. Feedback really should confirm an answer, but also add a little bit extra information, because it really is a learning opportunity for the students. So I've provided some more information to the students there. Once I finish my question, I simply click on save, and I'm then ready to add another question. It's that easy to create questions. Now let's create another question, but this time we're going to include a picture. So for the second question, we're going to click on true or false. We are going to add a question this time, and this time we're going to click here and add a picture. So we're going to grab a picture from my computer and use it in the activity. So I'm going to grab this map of Spain here and going to click on that, and then the question that I'm going to write is Henry VIII's. So I've completed the question here. Henry VIII's first wife was from Spain. True or false? The answer is true. And then I've given some extra feedback explaining that she was the daughter of Catherine, or was called Catherine of Aragon, and she was the daughter of the Reyes Católicos, and that she'd actually been married to Henry's brother previously. So we're trying to give some extra information. Remember, this is a learning opportunity, and it's one of the reasons why I particularly like Socrative. So we've now added two questions, and one includes a picture. Let's finally have a look at the short answer question. So we're going to click on this and make this the final question. Now, the third question that we're going to look at is called short answer then. You write the question in and you need to add possible answers. Now, strictly speaking, actually, this question is not even the answer I'm going to give is not correct, because actually it's not the clock that's called Big Ben. It's actually the bell, but most people think of it as the clock. So we're going to write Big Ben, and we're going to add also the chance to write Big with a capital B. So we're going to write Big Ben. We'll also accept that. And we'll also accept Big Ben. Now, this is the problem with working like this, because how many options are we going to accept as correct? For example, are we going to accept if the students write the answers all in big letters? So this is something you really need to deal with. And again, I need to put in some nice little bit of feedback here. Remember, as I've said now twice, this is a learning opportunity. I'm not keen on the short answer questions, because you've always got trouble with deciding what formats and what answers are acceptable. So I've written a nice bit of feedback. We've now got three question types. Now, of course, I can add more and more questions. We've got just three questions, but each one is different. We've done a multiple choice, a true and false, and we've also done a short answer question. We're going to click on save and exit now, because we're finished. And now it's simply going to bring us back to a list of all of our quizzes. And what we can actually do from here is various things. We can copy a quiz, we can download a quiz, etc. But we can also click on launch now, click on launch quizzes and quiz about Britain. Again, we're going to click on next, and we're going to have instant feedback. As I've said, that's the option I like best. You can read about the other options as well. And I also like to give the final score so the students know their final score. I click on start, and immediately, just like before now, the students would need to log in with that room number and they could begin to do the quiz. So that really is how you can work with Socrative and how you can create your own quizzes. I really hope you found those videos useful on Socrative, and you might want to learn Socrative in even more detail. And in fact, if you come to my website, there is a second set of videos that goes through Socrative in more detail. Come to the website, there's a newsletter that you can sign up to that gives you updates on all the latest videos and technologies that I've come across. But if you're not interested, just click here. The section where you're going to find more videos on Socrative is here. Click on mobile technology and you'll see that there's more videos, including Advanced Socrative and videos on Kahoot, etc. Now, the other section that you might also find interesting is Russell's 5-Minute Blog. And on Russell's 5-Minute Blog, there are very short videos that show you a whole range of other technologies that you might find interesting. In all of these videos are 5 minutes only. So if you click on any of the videos, make sure one thing: please watch the videos full screen. You can always click on a video and then open it up and watch it on full screen. Much better to watch the videos full screen than to watch them small size. Finally, if you're really interested in following my work, then also I add lots of videos onto YouTube. In fact, on YouTube, you'll find many videos that I do not put on the website. But as I repeat, if you want to do Advanced Socrative, click on the section Mobile Technology and you'll see a set of videos that says Advanced Socrative.